representing the Cabot Panthers tonight, their seniors. Number 71, Caden Tuck. Number 70, Shane Time. Number 61, William Carver. And number 34, Jacob Taylor. The seniors for the Northside Grizzlies tonight, number 3, Ezra Phillips. Number 33, Eric Brewer. Number 65, Damian Lopez. And number 77, Mason Medlock. Being escorted by the rest of the senior Grizzlies.
Hello and welcome back to Cabot Panther Football. Tonight, your Panthers take on the Grizzlies. Right now, the Panthers hold a top three position in conference. Fort Smith Northside are holding on to 6 and 7A Central, and with a win tonight and a few favors across the lower half of the conference, the Grizzlies could secure a spot in the playoffs. I will be your play-by-play commentator for the evening, Carson Cook, and sitting next to me, your color commentator,
Golden Hennessy.
Yeah, and only the top six teams make it to the playoffs, so both teams are looking forward to the postseason. But for tonight, Cabot is coming into the game 4-4, and the Grizzlies are coming in 1-7. Cabot looking to come out with a win on the road tonight.
As you just saw, our captains tonight are Caden Tuck, Jacob Taylor, Shane Tim, and Will Carver.
It's more than 14 state championships and fans screaming.
And all of them being seniors, you know, we don't really have very many seniors on this team. It's not like Cabot's just going to go downhill, as a lot of teams do, right after a year whenever they have a lot of seniors. That's not the case for the Panthers. The Panthers are coming in this game 3rd in 7A Central and 8th in 7A State. Wow, it's been a nice season for the Panthers.
Definitely has, and a lot of tough opponents to beat this year throughout the conference. Seems like almost every team is on an up year. But like you said, we've got a real young team here in the Cabot Panthers, a lot of sophomores that show a lot of promise, and not to mention the juniors. There are definitely a few seniors we'll be missing next year, but nothing we're not confident our ninth graders can fill in for.
Yeah, and I mean, the sophomores are just listed up and down our roster, starting rotational guys. I mean, just such a great young core that the Panthers have.
And today we will continue the tradition that has set us apart from any other. Ladies and gentlemen, we are Northside Grizzlies. Grizzly Sports Network presents your starting lineups.
About 4 minutes left before the game starts, both teams looking like they're getting ready to make their exits out from the tunnel. I'm sure excited about this matchup tonight. I've never actually been able to see Northside's field, and I'm glad to see it now. A real nice stadium they got here.
Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, it's just a great side. It's very historic. Mayo Thompson Stadium. I mean, we've got a great setup here. A nice press box, a lot of room. Very comfortable in here. And Carson, you know, the Panthers are coming off that loss against Bryant last week, a tough one it was. What do you think they're going to have to do differently this week to take care of Fort Smith Northside?
Oh, man, our offensive line is definitely going to have to tighten up this week to get a different result than we did last week. Later in the game, it felt like our offensive line just kind of, I hate to say it, but it feels like they fell apart near the end. Thought that we might have a chance to get back into that game, and unfortunately we just couldn't hold them. Defense just needs to lock down near the end of the game. They seem to have played a lot better in the first half of the game.
Yeah, and speaking about defense, you can't forget to bring up Gavin Vest. He's been out the past couple weeks with that hamstring injury that he's been battling all season. But man, what a piece we have back tonight.
Definitely excited to see him back into the game. And through five games, Gavin has 28 solo tackles, 4 sacks, 8 tackles for loss, 3 fumble recoveries, 2 caused fumbles, a blocked punt, and a pick 6 called back. An impressive stat sheet for the senior that only played limited minutes throughout these games.
Yeah, I mean, All-State as a junior, was looking to be All-State this year, and we hope he can still get into that conversation as he's led our defense all year long. And even from the sideline while he was out, we could see him hyping up his guys. You know, Gage Stamper was filling him in, and we saw that, you know, on the sideline, Gavin was over there like talking him up and showing him a few things that maybe he didn't understand.
And here come the Cabot Panthers. It's nice to see the crowd turnout we got here, even so far away from home.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy. I mean, we had a game earlier on. It was actually our first game of the season, first regular season game of the season at Fayetteville. And it was a pretty similar look. I mean, for a Panther team that's coming into this game 500 on the season, looking to just go over 500 against a struggling team like Fort Smith Northside, I mean, Panther fans staying loyal, and that's just something you love to see as, you know, as a high school, as a Panther football team.
Yeah, Northside at home, you can kind of tell that they're on a down year based off their crowd that they've drawn towards the game. Hopefully with a win tonight, for Northside at least, they'd be able to secure a playoff spot in the next coming weeks if after, like I said, a few favors in the lower half of the conference. But we were talking about Gavin Vest before, and it's hard to bring up. Well, never mind. Here comes Northside.
Wow. They
had an electric entrance for Northside.
Pretty impressive. But not something that I expected, not something I've seen. I mean, we've been to a lot of places this season, went to a lot of places last season, and I don't think we ever saw the main stadium lights that light up the field at night. I don't think I've ever seen them purposefully shut them off and turn them back on. I mean, wow.
Pretty nice, didn't it, Golden?
Yeah, it was very impressive with all of the lights playing in the background, the instrumental by Kanye West. And we were talking about Gavin Vest. Let's talk about his younger brother, the junior Keegan Vest. This season, he's been putting up crazy numbers. He's had 123 rushes for 529 yards. We know he's an inside run kind of guy. He just likes to run straight at the linebacker, straight at the defensive line, run people over, which we know he's so great at. He's averaging 4.3 yards a carry. And if you just hand the ball off to him and he gets 4.3 yards a carry, you'll find yourself in the end zone every single time.
Yeah, I mean, and after playing the tough D-line in Ruston and the incredible defenses of Conway and Bryan, 4.3 is a lot more impressive than most people like to admit. And here comes Lucas Blalack in the kickoff crew to kick it off to Northside now.
And Blalack, another one of those sophomores who's just been great all season long, consistent, and will look for more of the same.
The kick is up, and it's a deep one. Northside got it. They'll call it a touchback. And we've already got a Panther on the turf.
Being on the touchback, it'll be first and 10 Northside. Ball spot thrown.
That'll be number 89, Zach Brockman. He looks like there's a lot of pain going on in Zach Brockman now.
Yeah, we could just hope for the best. First play of the game, the last thing you want to see. But unfortunately, on fields like this, and the Panthers have a similar field, there's a lot of complaints over synthetic grass and turf fields because of how many injuries they cause. And I think we're seeing something that might not have been an injury on a grass field.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure what happened there, but Zach Brockman able to walk off the field. Nice to see him. Hopefully we'll see the senior back into this game later. But here come the Northside offense to kick off this game.
Yeah, and didn't need any help getting off the field, jogged off on his own. Hopefully it was just a little, maybe a little muscle spasm, something slight, that it won't affect him later on.
It'll be McLean Moody in the backfield and on the pitch. Brought down by Gage Stamper. That's Cameron Massey on the carry.
And Gage Stamper, the backup linebacker, making a play on this first defensive drive, first defensive play of the game for the Panthers.
A spread look from the Northside offense now. Moody dropping back to pass. He's got a man. That'll be number two, Rashawn Clark on the first down.
And that was just a well-designed screen play ran by Moody and the Northside offense.
Martin on the stop.
Moody. I hand it up the middle. And a tackle from
the Caleb Rudolph having an outstanding senior campaign. Rudolph, unfortunately, injuries have bit him, as well as a lot of players on this Panther team. But right there, looking as fresh as ever.
Switching it up, back in a spread. Moody looking to pass. He'll fake. And it looks like he was going to use his legs. He found his man in Ezra Phillips across the middle. That's another Northside first down.
And what a pass. What placement on that ball from Moody. You know, wearing the number 12, looking like Tom Brady out there, showing off a little more agility than Tom Brady ever has throughout his career.
A bunch look from Moody in the offense. Moody looking to pass. He's got a man over the middle. That'll be Ezra Phillips once again, and marching down the field is Northside.
Yeah, as it seems like they can't be stopped. What a tackle right there from Ross Baxter, but more impressive for Ezra Phillips to be able to hold on to that football even through the tremendous contact applied by Ross Baxter.
Well, second and short, two to go for the first down. McLean Moody, this time not alone in the backfield. That'll be another run play. They'll call that a yard past the first down marker and another first down for Northside.
Yeah, Northside's just not getting stopped here. I mean, they're playing very well on offense, playing above their record, that's for sure, as you wouldn't expect this out of a 1-7 team. And maybe that creeped into the heads of the Panthers, but surely that will be erased very quickly following this drive.
Another bunch formation from Moody. Moody across the middle. He's got his man with plenty of room to run. He'll make two men miss, three men miss, four men miss, and finally brought down by Ross Baxter. Body slam by Ross Baxter. He got all the way down to the 21. That's Isaac Wright.
Yeah, as we saw Logan Eason crashing with full abandon, reckless abandon, right at Ezra Phillips and missing the tackle and just drilling John Connor. But John Connor luckily able to get up.
Moody looking to pass once again. He looked to the left side and nearly intercepted by Noah Martin. I know that one hurts for Noah.
Man, right there with a great read. Noah Martin all over that. Looked like he was going to catch that and take it the other way. And maybe that's what he was thinking. Possibly running a little bit too soon.
And Northside, he'll definitely be hearing about that one, as the other game he had a couple dropped interceptions and he's just kicking himself now. But we've got to move on, and McLean Moody looking at 2nd and 10 now.
Yeah, but a deflection's a deflection. So no matter what, a stat is going on the sheet for Noah Martin.
Be another handoff. He's got the outside and brought down by Ross Baxter.
Be
Isaac Wright on the carry.
Baxter on the stop.
And that'll be another first down for Fort Smith, Northside. And what a drive they're putting together to open this game.
First and 10 at the 11-yard line. Moody will hand it off once again. He's got the outside. Only one man to beat in Ross Baxter, and he's not able to.
Right on the carry.
And DeCaleb Rudolph coming out of his defensive lineman spot to make a huge hit.
Rudolph on the stop.
I mean, just great mobility from DeCaleb Rudolph.
That'll be a holding call on Northside. Nice to see as a Panther fan, as that might just slow down the momentum.
and that's all we can hope for, as they've been playing with tempo. And tempo is what we saw against Bryant and Conway, which were both of our two toughest opponents for sure. And maybe Northside watched a little bit of film and realized that the Panthers have struggled to stop the tempo.
Yeah, definitely. They've been doing their homework. McLean Moody. Maybe a timeout from Coach Reed and the Panthers. Northside's been switching up their formation a lot here, and I kind of like to see it. Every time Moody isn't alone in the backfield, it seems to be a run. I'm sure that'll switch up soon.
Yeah, I mean, what we've seen from Moody, I mean, a lot of confidence in him as a quarterback, as the Panthers haven't been able to say the same much this season, other than last game where Charlie Powell put together an insane performance where he threw for 131 yards, as he's had multiple 100-plus yard passing games this season. And hopefully he'll get another one tonight.
About 8 minutes and 35 seconds left in the first quarter. Score still 0-0. Northside looking at 1st and 20 from Cabot's 21-yard line.
Yeah, Carson, we're hoping for a tough stop here in the red zone by the Panthers. This is going to be 1st and 20, like you said. I mean, not going to be easy for Northside.
Moody looking to pass. He's got pressure. He'll find his man. That'll be number one, Cameron Massey, on the reception. He won't get far, though. It'll be a one-yard gain.
And DeCaleb was the first one to get in there with an arm around him. But Stamper able to come in quickly and stop him at the line of scrimmage.
Eight minutes and ticking left. Moody looking at 2nd and 19 to go. Moody looking to pass. He's got his man on the outside, one man to beat. And he will, getting around and hit hard by Ross Baxter.
And that's going to be a fumble out the back of the end zone, touchback. It's going to be Panther football.
And what a lucky break for the Panthers, as it looks like they just might score after marching all the way down the field. Ross Baxter hits the receiver hard, and he'll drop it right before he gets it across the pylon. It's Panther ball.
And, man, a name that we will be saying a lot tonight is Ross Baxter. He's put together amazing performances back-to-back already, leaving his mark all over this game, and had 9 tackles last game. And, wow. And Panthers have the ball at the 20 now.
That's great for the Panthers, but that just has to hurt for Northside, as you thought you might just get in there. But Charlie Powell looking at 1st and 10 from the 20 now. He'll find his man on the outside, and Hayes Cox hit by the first man and brought down a gain of 6.
In a well-run route to the outside. I mean, solid 6-yard gain on first down, as we'll take 6-yard gains all the way down the field.
2nd and 4 to go for the first down. Reardon in motion. They'll give it to Vest. Vest up the middle. He's got 4 on the play. And they'll move the chains. It'll be 1st and 10 once again for Cabot.
1st and 10, ball spot at the 30-yard line.
And a quick first down, only took 2 plays. As Charlie in this offense, you know, looking to put points on the board first here in this first quarter.
Definitely looked like Northside was going to have that advantage. But Cabot and their offense with a lucky break, and it's been a very offensive game so far. Powell looking to pass. He's got pressure and not a man in sight. He'll throw it away, and an intelligent play from Charlie Powell.
Pass goes out of bounds. Flag on the play.
There's a flag down. Not sure what that's going to be for. Usually a late flag thrown like that is intentional grounding, but how could that be, as there was clearly a receiver in the area?
And they'll call an illegal man downfield. Make it 2nd down for the Panthers with 6 minutes and 40 seconds left to go.
Yeah, and tough break for the Panthers. But an offensive lineman clearly just went a little bit past the line of scrimmage. You just can't do that on a passing play as there's 6 minutes and 40 seconds left here in this first quarter. And the Panthers are looking to get on the board.
First and 15 to Concord. Before they can do that, Charlie Powell in the backfield with Keegan. And he'll pitch it to Hayes Cox. Hayes Cox trying to get around the outside. He'll be stopped by number three, Ezra Phillips.
Yeah, and mark that up as a pass play as we saw the pitch forward from Charlie Powell. And that's a play that we saw that you usually see in an air raid type offense where they don't run the ball much. As last year, like we saw with Mississippi State under Mike Leach, there was a lot of pitch plays that, you know, led to big plays like that. And, you know, Charlie Powell just racking up some passing yards on a free little pitch.
Second and one to go. They'll give it to Keegan Vest. And who else? He'll get that first down and more.
Vest on the carry, number 11, Zion Bishop on the stop.
Yeah, no surprise there. You're just not going to stop Keegan Vest before he picks up at least one or two. And, I mean, very rare that we've seen him get tackled in the backfield. And it's never just going to be one person to bring him down. It's always going to take two or three unless you take out his feet. I mean, what a player Cabot has, and for another year in Geek Invest.
Northside coach is not happy. They'll call a timeout.
Yeah, clearly a little bit of frustration from the coaches as there's 5 minutes and 37 seconds left in this first quarter.
Looks like quite more than a little bit from the Northside coaches.
And Carson, what do you think it's going to take for the Panthers to march down the field? I mean, they've put together a pretty solid drive so far. I mean, do you think they just got to keep it going?
Yeah, I mean, just more of the same, throwing different plays that Northside hasn't seen at this defense. I mean, and it's so hard to do later in the season as you've used almost all your playbook, especially with such tough opponents throughout the season. Nice to see them switching it up as the Cabot offense.
Yeah, and hopefully we'll get to see more of the same so far. Charlie Powell's putting together a pretty solid drive right here.
Charlie, he's got the screen pass. That'll be Hayes Cox. That'll be first down, and excuse me, that's not Hayes Cox. That's Evan Mathis on the reception.
And Evan Mathis put together a pretty solid season so far as another one of those juniors. Pretty young. And we see Keegan Vest coming out of the game, being replaced by Cooper Powell. And Cooper Powell has just been outstanding for this Panther team so far.
Charlie Powell alone in the backfield. He'll give it to Cooper, excuse me, not alone in the backfield. He's got Cooper Powell back there with him.
Zero on the carry.
And it'll be negative one on the carry.
Number 11, Zion Bishop.
I mean, what a play from the Northside defense. And, you know, just a tough run. They just sold out for the run and guessed correctly.
I mean, and it's not a bad guess when you're going against this Cabot Panther offense. Third and two to go. They'll keep Cooper Powell on the field. Keegan Vest nowhere in sight.
Yes, maybe the brotherly connection will be utilized here on this third down play.
We're in a motion. On the option, Charlie will keep it. That'll be a first down and more, spotted at the 46-yard line.
And just a smart decision right there to hold on to that one and pick up the first down.
It'll be first and 10 Cabot at the Grizzly 45.
It seemed like they were all closing in on Cooper. Charlie said, I can make stuff happen with my feet too. So we know that he was almost moved to the slot earlier in the season. There was a little bit of a few rumors circulating about that. But as we see, he is an outstanding quarterback.
And I'm sure glad those weren't true. First and 10 to go for Charlie. Give it to Cooper. A very obvious blitz package from Northside, and it'll pay off as Cooper will only get 1 yard on that play.
And something that's not going to make the stats or the stat sheet is Hayden Smith on that play. You know, dropping back, had a dude running full speed. It was a linebacker, from the Grizzlies, and what a block just to keep him. I mean, he would have absolutely smoked Cooper Powell in the backfield, but just great awareness and way to pick that up from Hayden Smith.
Nice to see that from our line. As on second and 10, they'll give it to Cooper Powell again. Cooper, with much better luck this time, he'll fall forward and get 11 yards on that.
Yeah, and Cooper just drilled Zion Bishop.
First and 10.
Made him look like a bump on the road, maybe like a styrofoam cup, just ran him straight over. As that'll be another first down for the Panthers.
I really hope there are no Northside fans watching the stream tonight. With 2 minutes and 54 seconds left in the first quarter, Charlie Powell's got first and 10 on the 34-yard line. Charlie looking to pass. Plenty of time in the pocket. He'll find his brother Cooper Powell. The ball is on the ground. They'll call it incomplete.
Yeah, pretty obvious incompletion. A hard hit from a Grizzly. But, I mean, Cooper Powell, that's just not an easy ball to hold on to. And even if he did, it would have been a very minimal gain.
Second down.
So, you know, not a huge hit to this Panther offense here on this great drive that they're putting together.
Second and 10 to go. Charlie Powell with Vest in the backfield with him. He'll get it out to Vest. Vest just shedding off the first Grizzly in sight. He'll cut left. And he just won't go down. Spotted around the 13-yard line. And not something we see often is that cut from Keegan Vest.
And Keegan Vest, I mean, it's just amazing to watch. He's just got a huge frame. And able to shift left and right like that, you know, you don't see that, like you said. I mean, you don't really see him making receptions. He's only had a few on the season, but right there, proven to be effective. Keegan Vest on that little dump off.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to call it poetry in motion, but he looked like a boulder out there as three Grizzlies it took to get him down in the open field. But Charlie Powell looking at first and 10 now, nearing the goal line. He'll give it to Vest once again. Vest got a hole up the middle. He spotted around the 10-yard line.
And a solid run from Keegan Vest. Able to pick about three or four.
Second 7, ball spotted at the 10-yard line.
And, I mean, if it's not broke, don't fix it. As Keegan Vest has been all over this game tonight. So we did see some snaps and some plays ran for Cooper, and he did just as well. And, I mean, just a bright future for this Panther team.
Definitely. As Charlie Powell trying to get the same play done that they did earlier. Hayes Cox on the reception, not able to get much farther than the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, and that was just read well by the Fort Smith Northside defense. I mean, a great play call. It worked very well earlier. And just looking to see if they could make it work once more. This is going to be third down facing the Panthers. But they've already converted once on third down. It wouldn't surprise me if they did it once again.
Charlie sending Reardon in motion. He'll pitch it out to Vest. Vest barreling through Grizzlies. It'll make it fourth and one inside the 5.
Yeah, and in this situation, not sure what the Panthers will do. It seems they'll be going to the Wildcat formation that's worked so much this season.
Oh, boy, you love to see that. 13 seconds left in the first quarter. It looks like they'll try and get a playoff. Cooper Powell about to take the snap with Keegan Vest, his lead blocker in front. He'll take the high snap, and he'll get the first down and more. Touchdown, Cabot Panthers.
Yeah, it's going to take a little bit more than one, two, or three guys to bring down Cooper or Keegan. And Cooper's showing that off right there. I mean, the Panthers have had so much success in that Wildcat formation. And just as the first quarter comes to a close, the Panthers put up 6. And looking to put up 7 is Dean Heyer.
Yeah, you were talking about production from our running backs, but production from our kickers this year has been incredible. Dean Heyer only missing one on the season. He'll put that one through. 80 yards and 15 plays was that drive. Cabot Panthers drive all the way down the field and put 7 up on the board to start off the night.
And I was talking to the Caleb Rudolph today in class, and man, he just said he was astonished at what Dean Heyer can do with his leg. I mean, just a sophomore, as he described him, a dog.
Northside looking to put some points up. They thought they were going to be able to get it the first drive, and it looked to me like they did. A very, very lucky break for the Panthers. And now let's see what Northside can do on the offensive side of the ball.
Yeah, it's pretty obvious that the momentum is in the Panthers' favor after getting that huge stop, and also after getting 6 or 7 on that last drive. I mean, momentum definitely on the Panther side. And another thing I was talking to Caleb about, he said that the Northside team has a lot of talent. And we've seen that through highlights on YouTube and on Huddle and all that. We've seen, I mean, some great highlights, as this team looks like it's full of D1 commits, but unfortunately have not been able to put together a great season so far. They've only come away with 1 win all year long.
Yeah, speaking of talent, McLean Moody, the junior quarterback, looked phenomenal on that last drive. I'm excited to see what he can do now. Lucas Blalack getting set to kick this one away. The kick is up. That's JT Thomas on the return, brought down by Gunnar Poe.
Thomas, solid open field tackle from Gunnar Poe right there.
On the stop for Cabot. First and 10
for Northside, and McLean Moody set up with decent field position on the 29.
And like you were saying, McLean Moody put together a great drive. He's been a fun player to watch so far. As clearly we're not rooting for Northside, but I mean, just to see his athleticism and his arm, I mean, it's just pretty impressive at the high school level.
Speaking of arm, he rifles that one to the flat. And first and more for McLean Moody.
Williams runs him out of bounds.
That'll move the chains for Northside. On the 43-yard line.
Yeah, and one play and a first down for McLean Moody and his offense. As the Panthers have definitely been struggling, and this Northside offense is far from one-dimensional. They can run and they can pass. And they're showing that here tonight.
Moody looking to the curl route. That'll be number 13, JT Thomas, on the reception.
Moody's pass complete to Thomas.
And JT Thomas just put together a nice return and already making a little play for the Grizzlies on offense 2 plays later.
Isaac Wright in the backfield now. Moody will pass it out to the flats off the hands of his receiver, number 2, Rashawn Clark.
And Moody just put that right on his helmet. A perfect pass, a perfect spiral, and nothing to come out of it. Unfortunate for Moody. But the Panther defense will take it.
Definitely, definitely. 2nd and 10 to go for Moody. Still accompanying, still in the backfield with him, is number 6, Isaac. Off the hands of his receiver again on the pass from Moody.
And another pretty solid pass. But a 3rd and 10 facing the Grizzlies offense. As it hasn't been on their quarterback, it's definitely been on the receivers so far. This Panther defense is playing fairly well.
3rd and 10 to go after 2 incomplete passes from Moody. Looks like a down that they'll go to the air again. Panthers will send one, and Moody will find the curl route. Unfortunately for him, it won't be enough. It'll be a gain of about 8 on the play.
huge tackle made right there by Mason Delamater. Delamater, a guy that, I mean, 35 on the ACT and a high-level safety for this Panther defense.
Fourth and short, they'll go for it. Deflected. And I believe that is Aiden Cook on the deflection and a much-needed one at that.
And Aiden Cook, the hype man is what we gave him. We gave him the name, the hype man, last game. And showing a little bit more hype there after making that huge deflection to force the turnover.
First and 10, Panthers ball spotted at their own 37-yard line.
First and 10, and Charlie Powell will come back to lead this Panther offense. We'll take the snap and hand it off to Vest. Vest with a hole up the middle through three Grizzlies. Finally brought down. That'll be number 32, Devin Jones, on the tackle.
And I don't know if I'm watching Keegan Vest or Derrick Henry out there. That huge stiff arm made the defender look way too little to be on the same field as Keegan Vest. Just an impressive stiff arm, impressive show of strength and athleticism from Keegan Vest.
I mean, did that look like the Beastquake run to you, Colton? Because it sure did to me, as Charlie Powell will have his running back Keegan Vest in the backfield once again on first and 10. And if it isn't broke, don't fix it. They'll give it to Vest once again. He'll get Vest two on the play this time.
I mean, ran over another defender as he's slow to get up after taking that huge hit from Keegan. I mean, I guess I would be too. I don't know that I would get up after getting hit by the bowling ball of Keegan Vest.
Second and 8 to go for the Panthers. Charlie and Cooper Powell in the backfield now. Fake the handoff to Cooper. They'll find Reardon. Reardon making a man miss, and he'll get the first down.
Great reception and a great show of athleticism. Went flying through the air after getting his legs taken out from under him. Gavin Reardon, another one of those academic weapons and weapons on the field. I mean,
he's in the running for valedictorian and the starting tight end. Very impressive. Second and 10 for Charlie Powell. He'll look to pass. Pressure in the pocket. He'll be brought down.
Dropped in the backfield by number 32, Devin Jones.
That'll be the strong hand of number 32, Devin Jones, on the tackle.
There's 9 minutes and 10 seconds and ticking left in this first half, and
second 17.
We didn't know how long it would take, but we're pretty sure of it, as there's been some struggles with the offensive line all season long, as there seems to be a hole right there, and they get to Charlie Powell.
Second and long to go. Charlie Powell looking to pass. He'll dump it off to Cooper. Cooper brought down by the first man.
Zero on the reception.
It'll be a gain of about 5 for Cooper.
And it'll be a 3rd and 12 facing the Panthers. It's not going to be easy for them to pick it up here. But you got to think, I mean, obviously they're never playing for a field goal, but if they get a little bit closer to that end zone, it's not a bad option. You have one of the most reliable kickers in the whole nation in Dean Heyer.
That'll put you up by 2 possessions no matter what. 3rd and 12 to go. I'll send Powell in motion. Charlie. Pocket collapsing. He'll look to throw, and what a throw! Looks like he got it to number 18, Evan Mathis. They'll call it incomplete. That'll make it 4th and 12 to go.
And here in no man's land with a sophomore leg like Dean Heyer, this is a extremely long kick. As it seems like, I mean, a punt here would be interesting to say the least. We know what Sam Dubwick can do with the football. And maybe what we'll see from the Panther offense is, you know, trying to get Northside to jump off sides a few times before they actually snap the ball. But here in no man's land, it's going to be tough for the Panthers on fourth and extremely long.
That'll be a timeout from Coach Reed. Reed not very happy with something on the field. It'll be fourth and 12 now.
Yeah, not sure what it could be. I mean, maybe some missed calls, but we really just hope for the Panthers to put together,
second of the half.
You know, a play that will pick up this first down, as there's really no other choice here. It's going to be a first down or a turnover on downs.
And it's not really a running situation from a running-oriented team. This is a This is a tough situation for Coach Reed and Charlie Powell. If I had to take a guess, they'd probably just give it to Hayes Cox and see what he can do. There's not much to lose on this one.
Yeah, I mean, Hayes Cox, just so quick and agile on his feet. You know, maybe we will see something from him, as he's been the predominant wide receiver on this Panther team all season long and was a main piece to the team last year as well, as he was only a junior.
Panther offense taking their sweet time to get back onto the field.
We see Northside heading back to their sideline. And we're talking about Hayes Cox. He has 290 receiving yards. But, I mean, after one of those plays that he made, he's either sure close to 300 or over. And what a season he's put together. I mean, in an offense that doesn't throw the ball that often, like the Panthers, to have 300 receiving yards as the season's not even over, it's very impressive.
Definitely like what we see from Hayes Cox. And tonight, and last game, Charlie Powell, I'd like to see what he can do, as he's really stepped into the role of the starting QB here in Cabot.
If there's a official timeout called, not sure what it may be for, but as we're talking about Charlie Powell and our quarterback situation, it looked like the Cabot offense was going to be pass oriented early on in the season whenever we got to see the brilliance of Maddox McCrory and what he was able to put together.
For Cabot, ball spotted the north side 31-yard line.
As I mean, he's tied for the most passing touchdowns on the team, as he only played two games. And both of the other quarterbacks have played all eight. I mean, that just goes to show you how impressive Maddox McCrory has been and will continue to be for the years to come.
Excited for the future of McCrory. Fourth and 12 to go. Charlie Powell looking to throw. He'll rifle it down the middle. And deflected.
That'll
be broken up by number 44, Lucas Caldevera.
And Powell was able to thread the needle right there and get it through a few Northside defenders. But unfortunately, the hit jars the ball loose. But not all hope is lost for the Panthers, as the Grizzlies don't come out on the field with the best field position, as it's going to be a lot like that kickoff return they had earlier in the game.
First and 10 to go for Moody.
I mean, we know he's just an outstanding pass rusher, but also outstanding in zone and man defense, as he can keep up with any receiver.
Moody over the middle, and what a acrobatic catch.
Unbelievable catch right there.
That's number 13, JT Thomas. We saw him on the return earlier. And that's just a freshman, Colton, if you can believe it. What a catch from Thomas.
Yeah, future's bright for sure for Thomas, as, I mean, he's already been able to make plays this game.
Moody, pocket closing, he'll use his legs and get around the outside. pushed out of bounds by John Connor before he can get the first down.
And what speed from Moody. As we know, he's been a great pocket passer so far. Hasn't really had to worry too much about the pocket collapsing right there. Great awareness and able to make a play with his legs.
Second two, ball spotted at the Cabot 34-yard line.
Isaac Wright, the junior back in the backfield once again at running back. McLean Moody will hand it off to Wright. Wright trying to push for the first down. He'll only gain one. It'll make it third and one to go.
Right on the carry for a yard.
And going back to what you said earlier, JT Thomas only being a freshman, you've got me looking over here at the roster over and over. We saw highlights from him this week whenever we were preparing for this game. I mean, just unbelievable. I just can't believe he's a freshman. I had no idea. And what a shock that is.
And you see him now in high school. Can't imagine him in junior high. As Moody will find the screen pass. Logan Massey Easton on the tackle. Massey on the reception.
As Logan Easton was the last man to beat for Massey. And an outstanding open field tackle made by Easton.
And we haven't seen a drive as nice as the first one for Northside, but this one put together quite nicely for Northside as Moody's pass will miss his receiver.
Martin in coverage, second down.
Yeah, and a rare bad throw from Moody, as that was an uncatchable ball and really the only uncatchable ball we've seen all game long.
Second and 10 now after the incomplete pass.
The Cabot defense standing strong here. Whenever they're getting pushed into their own territory, they seem to tighten down a little bit more.
Pressure, Moody looking down the middle.
Moody's passing two for Phillips.
It was intended for Phillips. The flag is on the play, presumably pass interference, as I'm sure you could hear a lot of Northside fans were begging for.
Yeah, and you got to think, at first the ref may have thought that that would have just been an uncatchable ball, but Baxter just had his hands on him way too early, so he wasn't even able to make a play. So kind of an obvious pass interference and a rare slip-up from Ross Baxter, as he's put together an unbelievable game and an unbelievable senior season.
First and 10 for McLean Moody. You have Wright back there in the backfield, right along with him. And he'll give it to him as Wright won't gain any on the play.
First player in there to make a tackle was DeCaleb Rudolph. DeCaleb Rudolph leaving his print all over the game as there's 5 minutes 39 seconds left here in this first half.
Second and 10 for Moody. Moody looking to pass. He'll get around the outside looking to use his legs, and he'll throw to the end zone. Broken up.
Moody's pass incomplete.
And Northside fans not happy with the no call on that, but the ball will get just to him as Preston Howard had the deflection.
What a play by Preston Howard. Unbelievable read. Was not really looking at the ball, but whenever he saw the receiver make a play, Howard dives for it and deflects it out of the way. I mean, just heads up. Beautiful play from Preston Howard.
Yeah, and a new face to see at corner so late in the season. Preston Howard filling that role nicely. Third and 10, Moody looking to pass, and he had a man and just missed him. Moody seems to be falling apart here on his third drive of the night.
Yeah, and the first couple, we thought that it was prime Tom Brady out there. I mean, unbelievable stuff he was putting together, but clearly there's a little bit of a rise and fall to his game. Maybe just a streaky player.
And it seems like McLean Moody and Northside are caught in no man's land on the 21-yard line. Moody looking to pass. He'll look across the middle. And he found his man, but John Connor with the deflection. That's a turnover on downs.
That's another one forced by the Panthers. Converted wide receiver John Connor making the play. And that was just impressive. What a stop right there from the Panthers.
And this defense, it seems, every time you get them on their heels, they strike back and stop you immediately. They'll keep the score 7-0. The Panthers lead.
And the Panthers have tons of time left on the clock as we see Cale Turner in the game at quarterback now.
He'll hand it off to Vest. Vest finding holes everywhere in this defense. That'll be about six on the game.
Number 20, Jalen Chavez.
As there's Keegan Vest just running through that line of scrimmage like a bulldozer. Took out nearly every player on that Fort Smith Northside defense before finally going down.
Send Reardon in motion. Turner will hand it off to Vest once again. This time he's wrapped up in the backfield.
Vest on the carry. Jones and Caldera on the stop.
It'll be a gain of about two on the play. That'll make it third and short.
And a smart tackle right there from Northside, as we know, going at Vest. Body is not going at Vest. Body is not going to bring him down. And the only way to really stop him is if you get him by the feet.
Turner leading this offense on third and inches. He'll send Reardon in motion. On the counter to Vest. Vest up the middle. Got the first down and more. He's spotted at the 38-yard line.
Phillips on the stop.
And Keegan Vest is just looking at making it look a little bit too easy out there. As maybe some frustration from the Northside defense, as it seems like Vest is impossible to stop. Looking like prime Marshawn Lynch.
And a Northside player will go down. Presumably just to stop the clock. With 4 minutes and 1 second left in this first half, the Panthers lead 7-0.
The Panthers have put together a pretty solid game so far. As we've known, they've started off fairly slowly, as they started off pretty slowly against Central a few weeks back, where they only had seven at the end of the first half, but then went on to score a load of points in that second half.
And if we can score on this drive, it'd be a bit of changing the narrative, as the Panthers have outscored their opponents in every single quarter throughout the season apart from the second. We'll see what they can do here now in the second quarter of this offense-oriented game here at Northside.
Yeah, and the differential in the second quarter has been really astonishing to look at, as it's not even close, as this Panther team has really just been slow all year long in the second quarter.
39-yard line.
Turner looking at first and 10 on the 39-yard line. He'll give it to Vest. Vest will fall forward for 5 yards on the carry.
Johnson on the stop.
A great run from Keegan Vest, and I mean, I said it earlier, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. As there's no need to even think about throwing the football whenever you've got Keegan Vest by your side at the running back position, as he's just been unstoppable.
3 minutes and about 25 seconds left to go in this first half of the football game. Cale Turner will hand it off to Vest once again. Vest barreling forward for the first down.
Vest on the carry.
He'll be spotted at the 49-yard line.
Yeah, just keep it simple. Give the ball to Keegan Vest every time, and you will get first downs every time. That's been the narrative all game long, as we finally see Keegan Vest coming out of the game. Maybe after running so many plays back to back to back, gets a little tiring. So we see Amar coming to the game, but a timeout called shortly after.
3 minutes and 5 seconds left to go in this second quarter. Northside will call a timeout to slow this offense down and stop the clock.
And Carson, this Panther offense has just been moving the ball really well. The run game not only helping us because it's picking up our first downs, but it also gets the clock moving so that maybe they can score late enough in this first half to where the Grizzlies don't have a chance to go back, drive down, and put some points on the board themselves. And they can take a 14-0 lead going into the first half.
And like we said earlier, it would be nice to score in the second quarter as the Panthers have struggled profusely with that all season. Kel Turner and crew looking at first and 10. Kreiner in the backfield now, the first time we got to see him on offense. Reardon in motion. Turner looking to pass. He'll get it to Hayes Cox, and Cox on the gain of about 5 on the play.
Turner's pass complete.
As the clock will continue to run, Cox was able to stay in bounds. Ticking now inside 2 minutes and 50 seconds.
Second five, ball spot at the 44-yard line.
And Amar, the speed back for the Panthers has been great. I mean, they just have a triple threat there at the running back position and have just been outstanding all season long.
Second and 5 to go. They'll fake the handoff to Kreiner. Kale looking over the middle and thrown behind and over the head of number 18, Evan Mathis. That'll make it 3rd down and 5 yards to go.
Number 20, Chavez on the pass.
There was a flag down on the field. So there'll be a holding on the Panthers.
That'll back Kale Turner and crew all the way to their 45-yard line, or excuse me, 46.
And Carson, what do you think the idea was right there, as running the football has worked all game long? You know, switch it up with 2 pass plays, and Kale Turner, maybe struggling with his arm a little bit, has nearly given the ball right back to the Northside Grizzlies.
Yeah, a lucky break from Kale Turner, and I'm sure they were just trying to keep Northside on their toes. They'll give it to Kreiner this time, and Kreiner won't get much on the carry.
Number 33, Brewer on the stop.
That'll be 4 yards. Not enough.
The 50-yard line.
It'll make it 3rd and 11 to go for the Panther offense, with 2 minutes and ticking left in this first half.
And Kreiner's a guy that can do a lot of damage on the inside run, but definitely does more on the outside run. Once he gets to the outside, there's very few players in this nation that's going to stop him, as he's just so quick and so fast.
Turner. Send Mathis in motion. Looking to pass is Kale Turner. He'll throw across the middle and intercepted. There's a flag on the play. That'll be a pass interference in favor of Aiden Tatum. But again, we see another poorly thrown ball that should never been in that traffic. As we're awaiting the call. And like I said, pass interference. That'll give the Panthers a lucky break and a first down.
Yeah, that's 2 lucky breaks for Kale Turner in a row, as the dropped pick earlier and then that one called a pass interference.
That's the penalty. It's a first down for
Kale. I mean, I don't know how much more Kale Turner and the Panthers can get lucky on throws like that.
1:30 left in this first half of the football game. Kale Turner looking at 1st and 10 on the opposing 35-yard line. Send Reardon in motion. They'll give it to Vest. Vest behind his line. Won't be able to get very far. It'll be a gain of 1 and 2nd of 9 for the Panthers.
And Northside clearly selling out for the inside handoff right there. As a pass over the top would be a fantastic idea. And we see what head coach Scott Reed was looking at for sure, but unfortunately Kale just wasn't able to find his guys.
a minute and ticking left in the game. Kel Turner will keep it, brought down around the 30-yard line. And timeout Panthers.
Rodgers and Brewer on the stop.
Is this going to be a third and five facing timeout the Panthers coming out of this timeout?
Their second of that.
Carson, what do you think it's going to take to pick up this first down and get some points on the board here with a minute or less than a minute left in this first half?
Rhythm and momentum. Something that we seem to have had early in the football game in the first quarter. Not so much here in the second quarter. Kale Turner now looking at third and five. They just need something to go their way so that they can move down the field more and more. But on a drive that we thought had plenty of time has turned quickly into just 53 seconds left. And on the 30-yard line, the way we've been getting stopped here on this drive, it's going to be a struggle to get into the end zone.
And the handoff has worked all drive and all night long. And it seemed as soon as they went away from handing the ball off inside to Keegan and Cooper, it has all gone downhill for the Panthers.
Reardon in motion. Kale looking to throw, just thrown in.
It's
incredible traffic. There is a flag on the play.
Yeah, clearly a design screenplay. But that might be one you got to throw away whenever there's four defenders in the area.
It'd be pass interference on the defense. Something I just couldn't even catch with all the commotion in the area. 50 seconds left in the half. That'll move the chains for the Panthers. And that seems to be three lucky breaks in a row.
Yeah, and the penalty helps the Panthers, not only stopping the clock, but also giving them a free first down.
Kale looking to pass. Pressure closing in on him. He'll throw it away, and it'll be incomplete. There's a flag on the play, however.
Intended for Dropkin. Flag on the play.
A pretty solid read right there from Turner. Nobody open. There's going to be a holding on the Panthers.
That definitely doesn't help. 42 seconds left in the second quarter. And Charlie Powell will come in for Kale Turner, looking to change the situation for the Panthers.
And the Panthers are not making it easy on Charlie, as it's going to be a first and 20 facing them, as penalties just been all over this drive. Really here in the past 5 minutes, there it seems like every play there's been a penalty marker thrown.
And if Charlie Powell can get 20 yards and score on this drive, I'll be thoroughly impressed. Charlie Powell will find his man on the outside. Reardon getting to the 14-yard line. And that's 11 already.
And smart read, smart play, and a smart guy to throw it to, that's for sure. The scholar and Gavin Reardon making the play on the outside for the Panthers.
Charlie looking to pass. He's got pressure. He'll use his legs. He'll throw it away this time.
Incomplete pass.
Not finding anyone and not finding any room to run.
Third down.
An intelligent play from Charlie Powell, but now he's looking at third and nine with 29 seconds left in the half.
It's not going to be easy for Powell and the Panthers here so close to the end zone. Things just tightened down a little bit more on defense and on offense, as it's just going to be the best team wins here inside the red zone.
Charlie on the draw will give it to Keegan Vest. Keegan Vest got room to run, and he's inside the 3-yard line and got a first down.
And that caught about everybody in this stadium off guard, as there's really not that many here on this home side. But, man, what a run from Keegan Vest to pick up the first down. Really caught me off guard, as it seemed like an obvious passing down to everybody in the surrounding area.
That'll be a timeout from Northside. 18 seconds left in the half. Northside freshly out of timeouts. Cabot dangerously close to putting six more points onto the board.
And that's really what we're hoping for here. And, I mean, they have a great opportunity to. The ball is placed on the 1 yard line. I mean, kind of obvious the game plan going into this play at the one, whenever you got a guy as big as Keegan Vest. And it wouldn't surprise me if we saw the Wildcat formation that we see so often.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was thinking, Colton, and I can't wait to see it. And I feel like it's almost guaranteed on the 1 yard line. But here we see Cooper Powell walking off the field and his brother Charlie still on it. Keegan Vest in the backfield, though, on the 1 yard line. Reardon in motion on the counter to Vest. Stopped in the backfield, but Vest just barreling through. And after the first man was just completely untouched, it didn't take much for Keegan Vest to get into the end zone there.
Yeah, one guy's never going to do the trick. As even if you leave one man unblocked running straight at Keegan Vest is going to win that fight 100%. And what clock management we saw from head coach Scott Reed. I mean, heads up to get the ball in the end zone with under 15 seconds left as Dean Heyer's field goal is good. I mean, that was best case scenario right there for the Panthers.
And a 4 minute and 51 second drive. 14 plays and 79 yards all the way down the field. Keegan Vest going into the half with 15 rush attempts and 102 yards.
Yeah, Keegan Vest just putting up unbelievable numbers this game. As we said, he was putting up about 4.3 rushing yards a game. Or excuse me, 4.3 rushing yards per attempt.
Number 13, JT Thomas.
But obviously, the script has changed as he's putting, I mean, a much better average into this game.
The kick is up from Blalack. And I believe that's Thomas on the return once again, trying to make something happen. He won't be able to. And finally brought down.
Thomas on the return.
And Thomas may be showing a little bit of freshman IQ. As instead of running straight forward, he started backpedaling a little bit. As Keegan Vest went from going 4.3 yards a carry coming into this game, and in this game he's put up 6.8 yards a carry. I mean, what a game he's having.
Definitely impressive considering almost every single one of those attempts are in inside runs, and he's hit at the line of scrimmage, and if not in the backfield. Very, very impressive from Keegan Vest. It'll be a handoff for Northside themselves as the clock will tick out. Your Panthers leading Fort Smith Northside 14-0. Join us in the second half.
It's Cabot 14, Northside 0.
opening our 2023 marching show of Frenda Celebration Live, here is the Mexican folk standard, La Llorona. From the senior class of 2024. Their leadership, effort, and example have been vital to our band's success. Maria Aguirre, Abby Aldana, Joshua Biddle, Maura Boyd, Eric Brewer, Lucy Buster, Alexis Castro, Ariana Castro, Ariana Chigola, Dennis Chavez, Landon Christenberry, Darian Clemmings, Melanie Correa, Sarai Duran, Karime Escobel, Jared Garcia, Emily Hernandez, Jolette Hernandez, Tashante Holden, Haciel Jara, John Joe, Evan Long, Joan Lopez, Mariela Martinez, Juan Martinez Gonzalez, Katie Mendez, Bianca Moreno, Fredis Najera, Jesus Ortiz, Eric Pilgrim, Jessica Relliford, Alexander Resendez, John Reyes, Allison Rivas, Eric Rivas Bibiano, Henry Rodriguez, Aaron Santos, Aaron Scantling, Garrett Springs, Sydney Taylor, Giovanni Velasquez, Ryan Warden, Alexis Wells, and Daxton West. Ladies and gentlemen, the Northside Band Senior Class of 2024. Featuring mellophone soloist Oliver Durham and dance soloist Addie Acevedo from the 2017 Disney Pixar movie Coco, here is the beautiful ballad, Remember Me.
Thank you.
originally an orchestral piece by Mexican composer Arturo Marquez, and featuring Zane Humphrey on trumpet, Gabriel Iribarro on alto saxophone, and Mariela Martinez on flag, we close tonight with Danzon number 2. Justin Boyd and Zave Music Company. Thank you for your continued support and go Grizzly.
Help us welcome to the field your Northside varsity cheerleaders. The 2023-2024 team is led by captains Heidi Wilshide and Georgia Beasley, and co-captains McKenna Borlin and Christina Wynn. Please also join us in celebrating our cheerleader of the month. Their teammates nominated them because they are helpful, caring, hardworking, and is always making the team laugh. Congratulations to Leah Blunt. Your music is on.
Talking about my boy, you ain't for the bad.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 2023-2024 Northside Insteppers. The Insteppers are being led by Captain Destiny Boyette and Junior Lieutenants Gabby Linsing and Melanie Rivera. The Insteppers are coached by Head Coach Katie Fawn and Assistant Coach Katie Becker. The Insteppers would like to recognize their senior Destiny and Justice. Thank you for your leadership this year. Please enjoy their prom routine to We Found Love. Chick-fil-A is here this evening and wanted to say thank you to the community of Fort Smith for allowing us to serve you for the past 21 years. It's our pleasure to serve you great food with genuine hospitality and a smile. Let's go Grizzlies, and always eat more chicken. Northside Grizzlies would like to thank their banner sponsors, Al's Barbecue, Blaylock Keen Air Plumbing Services, Sawyers, River City Realty, Southern Star, Center of Psychiatric, Rachel Fury, Bruce Stanton with Pradco Lures, Bandit Lures, Booyah Lures, Young, Monmouth, Hill, and Norman, Dermatology Center, Graphic Services, King Collie, Hardee's, George's, Burger King, State Farm Agent Brad Thomas, University of Arkansas, Fort Smith, Farm Bureau Agents Jeff Letting and Anthony Sims, Chuck Fawcett, Realty, Argo Medical, Brown Miller and Clark, Little Phil Oil, AAA Urinate, Dobson Fiber, Lindsay Realty, Matthew H., Scott Attorney, Arbest, Arkbest, McGrew Crew, The Asian Kitchen, First Students, Norris Company, Sweet Bay, Boyne Gasser Plumbing, Urgent Care, Doug Asley, Russell Exterior, Jelco, Horseman, Northwest Fire Protection, Godfrey Black, Fireplaces, and more. The Bill Stancil Memorial Press Box crew would like to thank a special thanks to head girls basketball coach Ricky Smith for taking care of all the press box food this year. Thank you very much, Coach Smith, from all of us. Whenever you get your 50-50 ticket out, it'll be announced immediately following the kickoff time. Tonight's take-home is $104, $104 for tonight's take-home of the 50-50 drawing. It helps to benefit the Northside Insteppers, and they appreciate your support throughout the year. The drawing will be held immediately following the kickoff. Northside would like to thank their corporate sponsors, Sykes, USA Truck, Bancorp South, McDonald's, Baptist Health, Mercy, First National Bank, Fort Smith, Taco Bell, ArcBest, Blaylock, King & Air and Plumbing Services, Hug, Chevrolet, Buick, GMC, ArcBest Bank, Cadell Reynolds, and Coca-Cola. The Northside Athletic Booster Club works to enhance the high school experience for Grizzly students, their families, friends, and faculty by encouraging and supporting active participation in student activities and interscholastic athletic programs. Become a 2023-2024 Grizzly Booster and helps support every Northside athlete in every Grizzly sport every single day. That includes tennis, cross country, track, basketball, soccer, softball, golf, swimming, bowling, baseball, volleyball, cheerleading, in-steppers, wrestling, and football. Join the Booster Club tonight, east end of the stadium at the concession stand. They also have a lot of merchandise for sale and fantastic deal on food.
Welcome back to Cabot Panther football. The Panthers will receive to start off this second half, leading 14-0. Northside looks to kick it away.
Yeah, Carson, this is the first time we've seen a kickoff from Northside all game long.
And a nice leg from Northside as Hayes Cox has got it on the return. Trying to get around outside, he won't be able to.
Number 32, Devin Jones.
He's stopped by number 32, Devin Jones.
Here is the winning number. 6-6-8-4-4-2-8.
The Panther offense will come back onto the field, led by Charlie Powell, looking at first and 10.
2-8, please bring your winning ticket
on the 29-yard line.
And a pretty impressive return from Hayes Cox to start off the half. It'll set up the Panthers with pretty good field position.
Powell will hand it off to Vest. Vest on the counter. Won't get very far. A yard on the carry.
We haven't got to say that very often. As Keegan Vest unable to get more than five. I mean, it was rare that he got stopped for less than five, as he averaged 6 yards a carry in that first half.
Not only 6, but 6.8, nearly on that 7-yard threshold. Second and 9 to go now for the Panthers. Charlie looking to pass. And wrestled down in the pocket. That'll be number 99, Taylor Webster, on the sack.
And that's a huge body for Northside. And unfortunately, Charlie Powell just couldn't escape.
Third and 19 to go. Feels like almost third and forever for Charlie Powell in the offense.
Yes, this one's not going to be an easy one to pick up. And in this situation, Charlie just can't force a ball into coverage. And really a pretty solid goal to set for the Panthers is to just get room for Dubwig to punt.
And they'll give it to Keegan Vest on the carry. He'll get a lot, but just not quite enough. They'll send the punt crew out, and the first time we get to see the leg of Sam Dubwig.
Dubwig, one of the best punters in the country. And we saw exactly what I figured we would see. Dubwig just getting some room, not having to punt from his end zone.
Congratulations to Daniel.
It's not exactly something we want to see all the time, but it's very impressive when we do get to see it.
Punt is up, and it's a good one. Carson Massey will elect to leave it alone and caught by Logan Eason.
Down by Eason.
As that one will be inside the 25-yard line. And what a punt from Dubwig. As maybe that leg a little cold, as he hasn't had to use it all night long.
And Colton, this Northside offense has looked good, although the scoreboard just won't show it as they're down 14-0. What do you think they need to change coming into the second half to get some points on the board?
Well, really, it's just been unlucky breaks for Northside that whole entire first half. And if they can put together another good drive like they had all that whole first half, and really the only key they have is to finish. They haven't been able to finish. They've been making plays like this one, which will pick up a first down. But they've been making plays in the early parts of the drive all night long. But it seems like once they get inside their 30, it's just lights out. I mean, they haven't been able to do a single thing. They have not found the end zone, and they haven't even kicked a field goal as they're scoreless here in the second half.
One play and one first down after the nice spin move from Ezra Phillips. Moody is looking at first and 10. On the rifled pass, quick down low. He's got a man that'll be number six, Isaac Wright, on the first down and more, about 20 yards on the reception.
And two plays, two first downs. As Northside's looking to move it quickly. But we've seen this time and time again, and just maybe Northside will be able to find a little bit more success whenever they get on their on the Panthers' side of the field. But it hasn't been too positive for them so far.
McLean Moody on the handoff. There's a flag, and they'll blow the whistle, the play to a halt, excuse me.
And we've seen that a few times as well. It seems like Northside is moving the ball really well, moving the ball with tempo, and then all of a sudden a little bit of miscommunication leads to a penalty that helps out the Panthers and does nothing but hurt the Grizzlies.
After the penalty, it's first and 15.
It'll be first and 15 for McLean Moody in the Northside offense. For the first time in the half, we'll see a spread formation for Moody. Moody will lose it on the snap and just fall on it immediately, backed up to their own 49. That'll make it second and even longer for Northside.
Yeah, and it's been unfortunate break after unfortunate break. This Northside team looks like they could compete with the best on one play, and then the next they look like they've never touched the football before. As that was not on the center right there. It was all on Moody, which you haven't been able to say much this game, as it's been his receivers that have been making the errors, not Moody.
And hopefully he won't let that get to his head, as Moody is looking at second and 21 to go. He'll throw one deep left side. A nice placed ball. His receiver just won't be able to get to it. Intended for number 30, Tavarius King.
Third down. Yeah, just a bit of an overthrow. Tavarius King was not able to get to that ball. As fast as he was running, you figured there was a chance. And all Moody had to do right there was give him a chance. But with John Connor draped all over you like that, it's not going to be easy to make a play, even if that ball is delivered more precisely.
7 minutes and 48 seconds left in the third quarter. Moody looking to the left side once again, and over the head of Gunner Poe, that's Cameron Massey on the reception.
And that might just be what the Grizzlies needed to swing some momentum in their favor. I mean, what a pass and what a catch. The play before, Moody had just overthrown his guy, but this time he won't let that happen, and he didn't let it get to his head.
And back to the line quickly is Moody and Carew, as they'll hand it off and gain one on the play.
And this Panther defensive line has played like a brick wall all night. They haven't allowed any runs to get by them.
No gain, second down.
As it seems like the offense for the Grizzlies is only coming through the air.
Moody on the screen pass.
Moody's pass complete to
After
Phillips.
Falling forward, Ezra Phillips will get four on the play. Excuse me, three on the play.
As that's Mason Delamater's second tackle of the game. A pretty hard hit delivered by Mason Delamater.
Moody looking at second down now. Blitz coming. He'll throw it quickly to the inside. And hit hard is the receiver, but he just won't go down. He'll roll into the end zone. Ezra Phillips will find the end zone for the first time tonight, making it 14-6. Your Cabot Panthers lead the Northside Grizzlies.
And I'm trying to keep my focus on the game here, but with the lights going off and on and off like that, it looks like a professional football stadium. Wow, that could lead to some crazy celebrations. Unfortunately for Northside, they don't have very many fans on their side of the field.
A point after attempt is up, and it is good.
The game is up and good with 6:36 remaining here in the third quarter.
6:36 remaining here in the third quarter. Cabot leads 14-7 over Northside, looking to put a couple more points onto the board. Cabot will get the ball once again.
And you got to think on that drive, Cabot didn't play too poorly as they forced. At first it looked like it was going to be a easy drive for the Grizzlies, and then a few mishaps led to a third and infinity. But what a strike.
And Rogers leading Springdale Harbor
delivered by Moody. I mean, unbelievable throw down field. As we were talking to some of the fans on the Panther sideline, and even they noticed that Moody is the real deal.
Yeah, very temperamental has this Northside offense been. They've been playing good offense all throughout the game, finding a couple tough breaks here and there, and finally they find themselves in the end zone, putting points and well-deserved points on the board.
It has not been easy for points to be put on the board. This Panther defense has been just unbelievable, as this is only the second kickoff of the game, and it's coming here in the second half.
Kick is there to number 14, Aiden Tatum. The Panthers will get the ball around the 35-yard line.
Yes, there's a little bit of extracurricular after the play on the field. But Aiden Tatum, another sophomore that has gotten a lot of reps in at the wide receiver spot, put together some spectacular catches last week. And in clutch moments against Bryant, and he was part of the reason the Panthers were in that game so late. The score wound up way more lopsided than the game actually was.
Powell will hand it off to Vest. Vest up the middle. Looked like the play was dead, but he'll get through that line and 11 yards on the carry.
Yeah, and we clearly see the weak spot on this Northside team. It's not their offense. It's not even close to their offenses. They definitely have one of the best offenses that we've seen all season long, but their defense just cannot seem to make a tackle. And whenever it's a guy like Keegan Vest, he's never going to make it easy.
Charlie Powell on the keeper up the middle. He's got room to run at one man to beat, and he'll bring him down. That's another 12 yards on this Cabot Panther drive.
And Charlie Powell, not the tallest guy, not the biggest guy on the field for sure, but one of the quickest, as it seems like he's in the pocket and then 10 yards downfield in a flash. What a run right there from Charlie Powell.
Charlie now looking at first and 10 on the Northside 41. Give it to Vest. Vest had lost the ball, but he'll regain it and make it back to the line of scrimmage.
No gain, second down.
And a lucky break for Vest. And one of his few errors. We haven't seen him, you know, lose the ball at all, hardly at all this season. And he's just been dominant all night and looking to continue to do more of the same.
With the clock ticking, about 5 minutes left to play in the third quarter. Charlie Powell looking at second and 10 on the opposing 41-yard line. He'll look to pass out to the flats. He's got his man in Hayes Cox. Cox with a little bit of room to run. And what I thought was a nasty stiff arm and impressive tackle, but not after a gain of nearly 20 yards.
And what a great play by Cox. Moving his feet right there. Great agility and great swiftness, but also what a block by one of the Panther receivers. Didn't quite see who that was, but blocked two guys for Cox in that great play.
Vest up the middle. He'll make it through the line untouched and get another first down for the Panthers. Excuse me, they'll spot it just short of the first down. It'll be a gain of 9.
And what a impressive run from Keegan Vest. just keeps dragging that whole entire Northside defense on his back.
Charlie Powell looking to the screen pass to Hayes Cox. Read perfectly by number 20, Jalen Chavez.
Number 20, Chavez on the stop.
But that's going to be another first down for the Panthers.
First and goal, from the 8-yard line.
First and goal, excuse me. As the Panthers looking to put some points on the board, and it seems like a bit of a revenge drive after giving up points on the last one. As they've put together a great drive.
Vest up the middle once again. Hit by just about everybody on the Grizzlies defense, but it won't stop him. That's another 6 points for Keegan Vest and the Panthers.
Yeah, that's Vest's second touchdown of the night. And you would think maybe two guys could bring down Vest. Obviously, one's never going
to
do the trick. But, man, it's taken about four or five from this Northside defense to even come close to dragging him down.
Dean Hyers' kick is up, and it's good. That drive, just 7 plays, 3 minutes and 65 yards down the field. Keegan Vest continuing to impress with 145 yards on the night.
And Dean Hyer, no doubt about it, caps it off. 21-7, the Panthers lead here in the second half. As, you know, it looked like the Panthers came out there with a chip on their shoulder. Didn't look like they were playing the same as they had been in that first half. And even at the beginning of this second half, whenever they got the ball first, they just looked like a completely different offense.
Definitely, and when we were walking back to the press box during halftime, Jaden Boyster looked at me and he said, hype me up, and I tried my best, but it seemed to have worked, as the Panthers will put another 7 points on the board and answering back to the Northside Grizzlies.
Here we get to see the impressive leg of Lucas Blalack. Not a guy that's going to kick it through the back of the end zone very much, but seems to be placing the ball.
Nice kick from Blalack, and it's muffed. Still, he'll get a couple yards on the return. That's number 13, JT Thomas, the freshman.
And another freshman move from Thomas. You know, you got to expect some plays like that whenever you just haven't been playing football as long as the other players on the field. But still, one of the many bright spots on this Grizzly offense.
Yeah, definitely impressive what he's done tonight. But like you said, it comes down to experience, and sometimes things like that happen. We can't really put it on Thomas. But now Northside comes back onto the field to see what they can do here, trying to score two drives in a row. Moody looking on the out route. He'll get his man and number one, Cameron Massey.
And what a pass and what a catch. So that's Moody to Massey, as they've connected a few times tonight. And just continue to have a very solid offensive performance.
First and 10 now. Ball on the 36-yard line. Moody tackled in the backfield. That's DeCaleb Rudolph on the sack.
DeCaleb Rudolph had a sack last week and decides to add another one this week, even with the very experienced quarterback in Moody. I mean, there was just no escaping DeCaleb Rudolph on that play.
I mean, and not only the play, but check out the celebration from DeCaleb Rudolph. Overall, very impressive and leaving his mark on the game tonight. Moody looking at 2nd and 18 to go now. Looking to pass. He's got pressure from Vest, and he'll throw it up and away. Pressure got there quick, and not much Moody could do in that situation.
Does it look like Moody could have had Ezra Phillips, but on the run with two huge Panthers running straight at you, it's never going to be easy. And I'm sure I would have probably done the same thing in his shoes. I mean, you got to be a little bit scared whenever you got two humongous linemen running straight at you. I mean, he looked like he was running for his life right there.
I mean, Bradley Barton and Gavin Vest is a scary sight. Moody looking across the middle. He had his man. That was number six, Isaac Wright. It'll just bounce off the hands, and it'll make it fourth and 18 to go.
And a great pass from Moody right there. Just poor hands. A little bit of butterfingers right there from Wright.
Number 15, Hayes Cox.
First time we've seen the Northside punt crew. Hayes Cox back to receive. Cox will elect to leave it alone. Punt will dribble all the way to about the 28-yard line. And here come the Cabot Panther offense once again.
And what a bounce right there on that punt. It looked like it was going to check up, but the second bounce sent it way into Panther territory.
Will Emmanuel Spaulding please report to the press box? Emmanuel Spaulding, please report to the press box.
But Charlie Powell on the offense for the Panthers coming out, as it will be Cooper Powell in at running back.
First and 10 to go with 1 minute and 57 seconds left in the third quarter. Charlie Powell on the offense starting on their own 28-yard line. They'll hand it off to Powell. Cooper, a gain of about 7 on the play.
And Powell to Powell right there, the brotherly connection, as it seems like there is a little bit of extracurricular going on the field, as there will be a flag down. But man, this Panther offense, we can just hope that it's on Fort Smith Northside, as it will definitely kickstart this drive and get them going after really a solid run from Cooper.
And that'll be a personal foul on the offense. That'll back the Panthers up after an impressive run. And not what you want to see as a Panther fan, but we've seen it a couple times tonight. Charlie Powell has been good about getting out of situations like this. Earlier we saw him in a first and 20 situation near the goal line, and he put 6 points up on the board, so let's see what he can do here.
Yeah, and they have two plays to make this happen, so it's the first down is not out of reach by any means for the Panthers.
Charlie looking at second and 18 to go. He'll fake the handoff to his brother Cooper and sacked in the backfield. Just not a lot of time to let his receivers develop. And that'll back them up even more.
Yeah, Charlie just had no help right there. I mean, it seemed like he faked the handoff and was hit right away. It seems like no blockers decided to pick up the two blitzing linemen.
Third and forever to go. 28 until the first down marker. They've got one play to do it. Reardon in motion. Charlie will keep it, and he'll get four, but not enough. Another late flag.
Gabriel Smith on the stop. Flag after the play.
Yeah, this isn't really what we would like to see. Watching up here, I mean, late flags after the play are just uncalled for and don't benefit either team, really. And we just hope that they can get this sorted out. But the Panthers,
that'll be another personal foul on the offense. I'm not quite sure what's been going on after the play, but the referees definitely don't like it, as that'll back up the Panther offense once again.
As it's fourth down.
27 seconds left to go in the third quarter. Fourth down and very, very long. They'll send the punt crew out.
As there's just not much room for Dubwig to get this punt off, but we know if anybody can do it, it's Sam.
Back deep to receive for Northside, number one, Cameron Massey.
Dubwig. The punt is up, and it's a low one, but it'll roll forever and out of bounds around the 43-yard line.
An unbelievable punt right there from Dubwig. From his own end zone to the other side of the 50, it's just not an everyday sight for a high school punter to be able to do something like that. I mean, the Panthers have one of the best punters in the nation, and that's without exaggeration.
The five-star proving his worth tonight off of just two punts. Moody looking at first and 10 now. He'll rifle one to the curl route. That'll be number three, Ezra Phillips, on the reception.
Moody's pass, complete to Phillips.
That was Gavin Vest in there on the stop.
And that play will bring the third quarter to a close. Your Panthers leading Fort Smith Northside 21-7 going into the fourth quarter.
And the Panthers have put together a pretty solid performance all around.
Cabot 21.
On defense and on offense, aside from a few drives where they've struggled to get the ball moving. And there's only been one drive that this, I mean, potent offense from the Grizzlies have found the end zone. And if you're a defensive player on that Panther team, you have to have a huge smile on your face after they've played just such an amazing game all around tonight.
Yeah, it's been impressive what the Panthers can do. Coming off a loss last week, nice to see the Panthers bounce back.
The Panthers will be taking the field now on defense. I mean, they've just been they've put together such a great game. You just got to be so proud of these guys. As they've played, I mean, whistle to whistle, they haven't, you know, let up, gave up, I mean, anything. They've all been playing their hearts out all night long. As it's going to be a three linebacker set for the Panthers.
Moody with protection. Intercepted by Gunner Poe. Gunner Poe's got room to run, and nobody's catching the one and only Gunner Poe. Pick six for your Cabot Panther defense.
I mean, if the offense isn't going to find the end zone, Gunner Poe says, fine, I'll do it myself, as he'll put up six on the board on the poor pass from Moody, and what a read from Gunner Poe.
And it seemed like the right read there for Moody, just a couple seconds too late, and Gunner Poe will make you pay for that one. It'll make it 27-7, Panthers lead, as Dean Heyer will come out to kick the point after.
And Gunner Poe, maybe with a little bit of revenge, he's had a lot of balls caught right over his head and been on the wrong side of some great catches all night long, but that time he says, you know what, I'm not gonna deal with it anymore, as he gets the pick six.
The point after is good, making it 28-7. Your Panthers lead with 11 minutes and 51 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Northside will get the ball once again. And after that pick six, it'll be interesting to see how McLean Moody reacts.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely going to be a bit of a test for how he comes back from making such a massive mistake. I mean, in all honesty, that was one of their last chances. Technically, the game's not completely out of reach, as there's still a lot of time left in this fourth quarter. But with how the Fort Smith Northside offense has been moving all game, you expected a little bit more out of that drive. But Gunner Poe.
Gunner Poe will put it into it quick if you're not careful. But like you said, this Northside offense and McLean Moody, have been nothing short of impressive, although the scoreboard just won't show it, as Lucas Blalek will kick it off once again.
The return is away. Plenty of space to run, but finally brought down.
Thomas
was Landon Oliveto, number 41, the linebacker, coming in and making the play.
Oliveto on the
Moody
side.
And the offense will come back and start at the 31-yard line. First and 10 to go now.
And this impressive Panther defense, we were talking them up earlier, right before that pick, so why not talk them up again, as they've just played a great game tonight.
The blitz coming, and Moody will get it out quickly. That'll be number 3, Ezra Phillips on the reception.
And John Connor showing the whole goal of zone coverage. They allow passes to be completed, but as long as they're right there, as soon as the ball is caught, all is well. That's still a solid game for Northside.
Second and 3 to go. Moody looking to pass. He'll find some room to run, but not for long, as that gap closes by number 66, Brent Bean.
Moody on the keeper. Flag after the play.
And forget the flag. Continue with the celebration. Have yourself some fun, Brent, as I'm not sure what the flag is on, but it was after the play.
Yeah, I guess you're not allowed to celebrate a big play, but so be it. I mean, whenever you're not at home, obviously a lot of people don't want to see celebration by the opposing team. But I saw absolutely nothing wrong, just a little bit of excitement from Brent Bean. And rightfully so, after making such a big tackle. But also a great use of legs by Moody.
And they'll discuss it and decide that there was nothing wrong with the situation. It'll make it 3rd down and 3 to go for McLean Moody and this Northside offense. With 11 minutes left in the fourth quarter, they'll need to make something happen quick to get back in this ballgame.
Yeah, even with the few fans in attendance for Northside, they still hear the boos. They seemed a little bit upset that they would allow even the slightest celebration.
Be an official timeout now.
So Northside coach has some words for the referee, it seems, but the Panthers will get time to get a little bit of water, to get prepared for this 3rd and short.
Colton, if you are the Northside offense, what's your approach here to 3rd and 2 to go, knowing that you have to get back into this ball game quick?
Excuse me, can you repeat the question? There seems to be a little bit of confusion on the field and confusion with the downs. The scoreboard says 2nd down, but the guy on the field says 3rd. Please repeat, please.
Of course, if you're the Northside offense, looking at 3rd and short here, what's your game plan knowing that you have to get into this game soon?
Well, I wouldn't really be in the spread formation. I would think to run the ball up the middle. But clearly they have other plans in mind, and the other plans will work. I was not going to say throw the football, as Moody had already made a pretty poor read earlier. But still having confidence in him, I mean.
You like to see it, as Moody, when making the right reads, has riddled this defense with short passes. As he'll rifle one over the middle, that one incomplete. Defended by number 30, Preston Howard.
And Preston Howard, a guy that we haven't seen a lot of this season, but tonight he's leaving his mark on the game. He's been pretty impressive.
2nd and 10 to go for McLean Moody and the Northside crew. spotted on the 43-yard line. 10 minutes and 20 seconds left here in the football game. Moody to the outside. Gage Stamper on the tackle.
You know, this Grizzly offense has ran a lot of spread formations. And we're seeing a lot more of that at all levels of the game, as that was first mainly a thing in college and then moved to the NFL. And as it's such a difficult thing to perfect, a few high schools are adopting it. The Panthers staying true to their identity, which has worked here for them tonight, as they're leading 28-7.
Blitz coming. Moody almost had his man, through the hands of Isaac Wright. That'll make it fourth down and not so manageable. 4 yards to go. It looks like the punt crew will come out for Northside.
I mean, interesting call right there to bring out the punter, as it seems like to get back into this game, they need points early and often. But at the end of the day, I'm not a head coach, so I don't know exactly what's going on with my players on the field.
Punt nearly blocked. Low. Cox will elect to return it. About 20 yards sideways and 2 yards forward. He'll get it back to the 20-yard line.
Number 6, Isaac Wright on the tackle.
There's just inside 10 minutes with 9 minutes and 59 seconds remaining here in this fourth quarter. Cox will have to come off the field as his helmet came off.
But and here we see Cale Turner coming back onto the field, starting at the 19-yard line. With 10 minutes left to play in the game, you can only imagine that it's going to Keegan Vest to try and control this clock a little bit. And Vest
on the carry,
running over his own blockers, he'll get 1 yard on the gain.
I think everybody in the stadium knew what was coming right there.
Gain of 1, 2nd and 9, ball spot.
As Vest will only pick up a yard. But yeah, just looking to drain the clock here are the Panthers. So I'm sure we'll see a lot more of the inside handoff.
They'll fake the handoff to Vest and to Dominic Delator. An impressive catch for about 3 or 4 yards.
Turner's pass complete to Delator. Phillips in coverage. 3rd and 5, ball spot.
And Delator, a younger guy listed as a junior, making an impact on the game. A tough ball to catch, not in the best location, but still able to make a play.
3rd and 5 to go. They'll go to Keegan Vest. Vest, he'll get the first down, and Moore spotted around the 34-yard line.
And why not 3rd and 5? I mean, 3rd and 20. It's not even – it's never a bad idea to hand the ball off to Keegan Vest, as he's always a threat to break loose and pick up big yardage.
Turner looking at 1st and 10 once again. They'll hand it off to Kreiner. Kreiner up the middle. He'll fall forward and get about 3 yards on the play.
Brewer on the stop.
And a pretty solid run right there from Kreiner. If he can just keep doing that, the Panthers will continue to drain the clock and be home free with a victory.
About 8 minutes left to play in the game. 2nd and 7 to go for the Panthers.
As there was clearly a Grizzly that jumped off sides, but no call.
The pitch to Kreiner. Kreiner, not much room to work with. Brought down around the 39-yard line.
on the carry, stopped by Ezra Phillips.
And from up here, it looked like a horse collar. Kreiner was dragged down by the back of the jersey. But from so far away, I mean, a lot of times it could just be the shoulder pad. As I'm sure y'all at home had a better view on that one.
Kreiner not being able to stay in bounds. It'll stop the clock at 7:35 left in the game. Kreiner with a gain of 2 on that play, and it'll make it 4th and short.
Hey, shoot on the stop. 4th and 2, ball's caught at the 41-yard line.
And an interesting drive game plan from the Panthers.
And it looks like the Panthers won't use all 4 downs to go for it. They'll send Dubwig back onto the field.
I mean, 7 minutes isn't much time, as there's, this is just inside 7 minutes. But you might be a little afraid that there's still some chance for a comeback.
And almost hitting Gunnar Poe in the top of the head. That punt will make it all the way back to the 9-yard line.
Oliveto.
It looked like Cameron Massey wanted to return that ball and just couldn't, because of the sheer height of the punt. With 6 minutes and 41 seconds left in the game, Northside will come back onto the field down 21.
And a professional level boot right there from Sam Dubwig to pin. As the ball was down inside the 9, but moved up to the 17, not sure exactly what happened. But it will be Northside with the ball.
Seems like Gunnar Poe may have gotten a hand on it on accident. And another interception, this one for John Connor this time. John trying to get it all. He won't be able to. He'll bring it all the way back inside the 15-yard line. If we look back a couple weeks, John Connor, this isn't his first interception. His first game as a defensive back, he had one of the most spectacular interceptions I've ever seen, and here he comes away with another one.
Yeah, showing off that wide receiver skill that he had at the beginning of the year. Moved to special teams, then moved to safety, and just been making plays ever since. I mean, he was making plays as a wide receiver for sure, but, I mean, equally a threat on defense as well.
And McLean Moody looked so good all night, but then that just wasn't an ideal pass, and John Connor will make you pay for it as Cale Turner looks at 1st and 10 inside the 15. Hand it to Powell. Powell will find a hole,
0 on the carry.
Get it all the way to the 10-yard line.
And Cooper Powell showing flashes of similarity to Keegan Vest, as that play seemed busted at before the line of scrimmage, but able to pick up more as there's 6 minutes and 10 seconds and ticking left in this fourth quarter as the Panthers have the ball inside the red zone.
Cale Turner will hand it off to Powell once again. This time, he's stopped early by number 34, Malachi Warren, the sophomore.
Number 0 on the carry.
That'll keep the play clock ticking. 5 minutes and about 30 seconds left to go in the game. Third and 5 for Cale Turner in the offense.
And right here, the Panthers looking to pick this one up. We'll probably stick to the ground game, however, just to keep the clock rolling. As they also know that they have a guy named Dean Heyer.
Exactly. Cale Turner will keep it on the bootleg. He'll try and get it to Dominic De La Torre. He won't be able to, and it is incomplete. 4th and 5 now. That'll stop the clock.
Number 20, Jalen Chavez.
And as you could imagine, they'll bring Dean Heyer and crew out onto the field.
Yes, Cale Turner, a crossbody throw on the run to a well-covered De La Torre. It's never going to be an easy pass, not even for Tom Brady to make. But Cale Turner was not able to find De La Torre. But luckily we have this guy, Dean Heyer.
Luckily indeed, as Dean Heyer will put another three on the board for Cabot, making it 31-7. Cabot lead with 5 minutes and 6 seconds left in the game. Northside and McLean Moody are going to need a lot more and nothing short of a miracle to get back into this one.
Yes, it's definitely not going to be easy. It's not going to be easy for the Grizzlies to get back, especially with Moody and his struggles here in this fourth quarter, as he's definitely not been on like he was earlier in the game, where he was showing flashes of Patrick Mahomes out there, now showing flashes of one that I would hate to say, Mississippi State alum Dak Prescott.
Yeah. As you know, and I'm sure you just hate to hear, Dak Prescott last year just didn't have an incredible season with a ton of interceptions. Moody definitely showing flashes of Prescott here tonight. Blaylock, the kick is up. And the Grizzlies got it once again inside the 10. He'll make the first man miss, but not the second. Ross Baxter will bring Thomas down around the 29-yard line.
Baxter on the stop.
And interesting, we see Zach Brockman on the special teams unit going to make tackles as he was the starting tight end for a short portion of the season there towards the earlier weeks in the season. But if he can do it, he can do it, man. I know he's a talented athlete and continues to impress everybody on the field.
Just inside 5 minutes left to play in the game. McLean Moody and the Grizzly offense will come back onto the field. Looking to throw deep is Moody. He'll try and find his man in Ezra Phillips. It'll be incomplete.
Second down.
As Ross Baxter went to make a play on Ezra Phillips. Really, if he hung back a little bit, obviously not the smart play. As if Ezra would have came down with the ball, it would have been better for him to be right there to deliver the hit. But on that play in particular, if he hung back a little bit, he might have been able to come away with an interception. That would be the third interception by the Panther defense on the night.
Second and 10, Moody looking for his man and Cameron Massey nowhere near. And that'll make it third and 10 to go with 4 minutes and 50 seconds left in the game.
Yes, Moody not the same player that we saw in the first half. Maybe slightly frustrated here in the second because we know he's capable of making those throws. And missing like that is just not something that he has done throughout this ball game.
I think Moody just letting the pressure get a little bit to his head here. As Moody, he'll look to throw once again. This time he'll find his man. A good throw, but not so much of a good catch from Cameron Massey. It'll be incomplete and fourth down and 10 to go as the Northside punt crew will see the field once again. We've seen them a lot more here in the second half than we did in the first half.
Man, just really tough for McLean Moody. I mean, he put together a great night. He made plays when he needed to make plays. But unfortunately for him, his receivers have been the ones holding him back for the most part, as this game would look a lot different with a few less dropped passes.
The punt is low, and Hayes Cox will elect to leave it alone, and it'll dribble out around the 40-yard line. With 4 minutes and 37 seconds left to go in the game, Cabot leads 31-7 over Fort Smith Northside.
Yeah, and you got to think the game plan's pretty simple right here. Just inside runs, just drain the clock, and hopefully we'll get to see a little victory formation if they're able to move the ball and pick up a few first downs.
That'll be Kale Turner and Amar Kreiner in the backfield now, looking at first and 10 on their 40-yard line. 4 minutes, like I said, 4 minutes and 37 seconds left in the game. They'll hand it off to Kreiner up the middle.
Kreiner on the carry.
A gain of 1 for Kreiner.
Yes, this is where the game really slows down for the Panthers. Just wait as long as possible for that play clock to get as low as possible. But man, what a game the Panthers have put together so far.
And here we have Nate Gaines coming in for Dominic De La Torre here on 2nd and 9. They'll keep Kreiner in the backfield. Tight end Reardon in motion. They'll give it to Kreiner up the middle once again. Kreiner will fall forward and get the first down. Almost looked like a punch was thrown from the Grizzly defender. But instead, it'll be a first down and 10 to go on the 50-yard line for Kale Turner.
Yes, there's definitely been a little bit of animosity on the field, but the Panthers have dealt with it very well, dealt with their emotions very well, as they're able to come into Fort Smith Northside and take a win from them on their own senior night.
Turner will find his man in number 11, Jordan Van Gordon. There's a flag on the play, however. Nice to see Kreiner in the game, but the pace that Keegan Vest was moving earlier was well on his way to 200 yards on the night. Unfortunately, if he doesn't come back into the game, which I'm not sure we'll see him again, he'll have 155, averaging a calm 6.7 yards a carry.
I mean, nonetheless, just a fantastic game for Keegan Vest and the whole Panther offense, as they've put together some great drives, as the Panthers will be backed up.
Not what you want to see for the Panthers. 4th and 25 to go.
After the penalty, 1st and 25.
Or first, excuse me, I'm sorry.
I mean, it's been a long game, Carson. I'm sure everybody understands. But, man, what a game it's been. The Panthers playing just so well.
Kreiner up the middle. This one stopped quickly. That'll be number 10, Warren Bijou, the sophomore.
Yeah, and with the small crowd that was on this north side of the field, it's very quickly thinning out. It kind of looks like, I don't know if you remember watching the game on Saturday, Arkansas versus Mississippi State. There towards the end of the game when everybody was just filing out, it looked like the floodgates were open as everybody was trying to get out of the stadium as fast as possible because they just couldn't believe what they had seen.
I'm sure you love that as a Mississippi's fan, as Kale Turner will keep the ball. He'll lose about 1 on the play. Never mind, they will say that he made it back to the line of scrimmage, and it'll be 3rd and 27 to go.
No gain.
Well, I'm sure we would all like to see a first down picked up here, but 3rd and 27, definitely not an easy one, especially while you're just trying to drain the clock as much as possible, as they took it down from 9 minutes to under 2 in one drive. I mean, wow. That's crazy ball control.
1 minute and about 30 seconds and ticking left. Turner will hand it off to Kreiner. Kreiner trying to get around the outside.
He won't be able to.
He'll get it to about the 40. Still 20 yards short of the first down.
The right team, Gabriel Smith, led the way for the north side defense. 4th and 10.
About a minute left on the clock and ticking. Cabot leads 31-7 as they punt it away to Northside. There'll be about 13 seconds left on the play clock. I'm sure they'll run it down as far as possible.
Yes, there's no reason not to, as they let it get within five.
Dubwig on the high punt. He'll try to return that to number three, Ezra Phillips, but he won't be able to inside the 10-yard line. Gunnar Poe, the one and only with the tackle.
Man, what a punt from Dubwig. I feel like in this situation, with the Panthers having such a comfortable lead with no hardly any time left in this fourth quarter, I mean, I think it's okay to say that seeing Dubwig right there showing off the leg, not really something you're upset to see, as the Panthers have played just outstanding all night long.
And I feel like we've just been a little bit spoiled with such a nice punter, as with a nice move, running back will gain about 4 yards on the carry. About less than 30 seconds left to play in the game.
Taylor on the stop.
Looks like Northside might just let the clock tick out.
Yes, they seem to want to get out of here as quickly as possible. That's definitely been a rough one for them tonight, as they'll let the clock tick down and walk to their sidelines. And what a game from the Cabot Panthers, securing the win 31-7.
Yeah, definitely. Both offenses coming out looking phenomenal. Northside just with a couple bad breaks and seemed to have lost their edge later in the game. An impressive win for the Panthers tonight, coming out victorious after a hard-fought 31-7 win here in Fort Smith. Join us next week at home against North Little Rock and dress up in your 24-karat gold attire for senior night. This is Carson Cook
and Colton Hennessy
signing off. Have a great night, Panther fans.